Alright guys, welcome to your third loader tutorial, and this video we're talking about observing data. So we're going to do some very basic stuff. This is going to be quite short. I'm just going to make this a linear layout actually. Oh, frick it, frame layout's good. We'll just add the button down here. So I'm going to very quickly Android text, force load. So it's, as you can see, it's overlaying the top of the list, but that's fine. Nobody gives a damn. Button force, good stuff. And then we just, in our main activity, and say find view already. Set the on-click listener, get ready to do that, and then that's what we're going to do. So that's basically our button now set up, ready for clicking. So what we're going to do is we're going to create an anonymous inner class again. I love these things. I'm just going to create a broadcast receiver, okay? Okay. And what we're going to do is we're going to create an action. So we're just going to make a public. Actually, here's a great trick. Public static final string. This string is just arbitrary. I generally use the Android style. But anyway, yes, that's essentially our action. So what we're going to do is we're going to, in our onstart loading, so the loader, as I said, went in our first video, the loader goes through a couple of different stages. It goes through a starting stage, stop stage, and a destroyed stage. So what we want to have is we want to tell the loader to start observing data in the starter stage, and then when it's reset or when it goes into the destroyed stage, to stop observing that data, because we don't give a damn about it at that point. The loader's gone. So in our onstart loading, before all this, we're going to register our broadcast receiver here to listen for changes. Now we're going to do it on the local broadcast manager, because the local broadcast manager is local to your app instance. It doesn't broadcast them out to the system with a context. So we're going to create local broadcast manager to get instance this, or get context. Okay, now we need to create an intent filter. And then we put it pass in our action for that filter. And then we want to say manager.registerReceiver, broadcast receiver, and our filter. Okay, good stuff. So now we've registered our broadcast receiver. And then what we need to do is we need to tell in on reset. This basically means don't do anything. Stop on what you're doing. We're going to get our broadcast receiver again. And we're going to unregister our receiver. So this is a tidy up, and essentially on reset means clean up whatever you have. Now you can use loaders to load bitmaps into your UI if you're crazy. I use a custom library for that, the crossbow library I made, or the extension of Volley I made called crossbow to do loading. But in the case where on reset, if you're doing anything up here, so these are just a list of strings, okay. But if you're doing anything super heavy, like very memory intensive, huge model lists, in here you want to tidy them up. So when you're on reset, you want to destroy, release any memory, just get rid of all the crap. Anyway, so there's our broadcast receiver. And in here, we're just going to call force load. Okay? Now, there are other things you can do, like commit content change, on content change, and all these flags you can set. I don't like setting them because they're very frustrating. And I don't... They tend to introduce a lot of complexity that's not needed. So essentially we're just going to call force load, and that will essentially force load and background to load. New data will be delivered, it'll be cached, it'll come up to the activity, and the swap data will be called. Good stuff. In fact, I won't do that. Okay, I had an idea. So now we just need to make an intent to broadcast. I'm just using intent broadcast receivers because they're quick and dirty. So I pass in our action, get our local broadcast manager dot get it's not an action activity, it's a main activity. Send our broadcast to our intent. Okay. So whenever we click that, we should force load. So we're just actually going to put a log in here, okay? And that's a class I don't use. Loading new data. Now, one thing you need to be aware of is that sometimes the loader won't call on load finished every time. If the data set changes and new data comes in, but if the data is identical in every way, like this, at least the strings will be identical, so most likely this won't actually get called, but we'll be able to see it loading the data twice because the loader will do its own kind of semi-internal caching. So anyway, let's just run this and we'll be able to see it load new data in the logs and then load new data again. So it's going to filter for my tag. What did I do? D. Okay, so as you can see here, we have loading new data right here, and our data is loaded. So we're going to click force load, and as you can see, it loaded new data. So this is very useful if you've got, let's say, or very, very useful if you've got a a service that runs when your app starts and it downloads, you know, an updated list of pictures or something, or URLs or something to a file or to a database. You can actually, like, at the end of that service, send out a broadcast, the intent service, you know, oh, broadcast that's updated, and you can have loaders monitoring that data set and go, oh, I've got new data to load, and then that list will populate itself. So in here, if you could take out the button, now let's say we're sending this broadcast from somewhere else, the activity doesn't know about the data changes. The loader handles everything internally, and that's what I find so brilliant about loaders. They handle everything internally and they're great for this kind of stuff. So anyway guys, that's it for this video, and the next video we're going to do is going to be crazy stuff. We're going to make a network call inside a loader. We're going to write a custom loader. It's not an async task loader. We're going to make a network call, we're going to cache it, and we're going to be awesome. Anyway guys, that's it. See you next time.